everybody, welcome to Kathy's Crazy Kitchen once again. We are doing our spice segment, and I am excited because right now it smells beautiful in my home. Why? Because I'm using two spices. Today we are talking about cinnamon and nutmeg. And I guarantee you by the end of this session, you're going to be wowed by what I'm about to tell you. Now, cinnamon comes from the bark of a cinnamon tree. Did you know there are two different types of cinnamon? That's right. There's the Cassia cinnamon and the Ceylon cinnamon. Today, we're going to be talking about the Cassia cinnamon. Why? Because this is probably the cinnamon you use the most in your home. Now, what's the difference between the Ceylon cinnamon and the Cassia cinnamon? Well, I will tell you, they both have a compound of coumarin. Now, the Cassia cinnamon has a much higher compound of coumarin, which means that it's not as healthy for you as the Ceylon cinnamon. The Ceylon cinnamon is a lighter brown color, whereas the Cassia cinnamon, you can immediately see the difference because it's much redder in color and darker brown. So, how does it smell? Well, the best way to describe cinnamon is it's a very warm and uplifting sweet smell. And the flavor of cinnamon is a little bit of sweet and savory, but a hint of spiciness. What are some of the positive health benefits of cinnamon? Well, it's loaded in antioxidants, it has an anti-inflammatory, it may cut risk of heart disease. Cinnamon is most commonly used in desserts and alcoholic drinks, now especially with apples, peaches, pears. It really brings out the flavors of your dessert. Although I will tell you, with cinnamon, one of the things you have to be very careful about is you don't want to overuse cinnamon. And the reason why is because not only does it have a lot of positive health benefits, it also has negative health benefits. It can damage your kidneys if you use too much, your liver, it can thin out your blood. So, I mean, if you're going to use it, you're going to want to use it in small quantities. So that's all we have to say about cinnamon. I mean, if you want to learn more about the Ceylon cinnamon, maybe later on in our next session we'll talk about the different types of spices that go with the other spices, and that's when we'll mention the Ceylon cinnamon. Okay, now it's time to talk about nutmeg. Well, let me tell you, nutmeg, again, very unique spice. Did you know that the shell of the nutmeg is not nutmeg? It's actually mace. Nutmeg is actually a seed that comes from the dark evergreen tree. And the seed, when you grind it, is what gives you this lovely nutmeg, earthy texture to it. It is a little expensive. It's a more expensive spice, I will tell you that. Now, the flavor of nutmeg is, again, it's a very warm, slightly sweet, but nutty flavor. You want to talk about the smell, well, put yourself in the middle of a forest and that's really the smell you're going to get from this beautiful spice. Nutmeg has a wide variety of uses. I'm talking people will use it in their baked goods, their puddings, potatoes, sauces, vegetables, beverages like eggnog and apple cider. Nutmeg goes great in those beverages. So what are the health benefits of nutmeg? Well, it relieves pain, soothes indigestion, strengthens cognitive function, detoxifies your body, boosts skin health, increases the immune system, improves blood circulation. So nutmeg, once again, you don't want to use in large quantities. And the reason why is because if you use way too much nutmeg, well, first of all, you're not going to get the flavor you're looking for. You don't want to overpower your food with a nutty flavor. So that's the number one reason why. But most importantly, the risks of using too much can be devastating to your health. I'm talking, you can start feeling nauseated, it'll give you dry mouth, dizziness, irregular heartbeat, agitation, and even hallucinations. And I'm sharing so much more. We're going to be talking about starches in the future. We're going to be talking about vinegars. We're going to be talking about all of the things that you need to know before you use the ingredients in your kitchen. So thank you once again for joining me here at Kathy's Crazy Kitchen. I'm loving what I'm doing. I hope you are too. I think it's very informative information if you're going to use spices. And let's face it, when you cook in the kitchen, it all starts with flavor. But join our YouTube channel. Check out some of our fun videos. We're just here to talk about food, engage with you, inspire you, and have fun. And if you really want to learn more about recipes or you would like to get in-depth with information about these two spices, I do have a blog, www.kathyscrazykitchen.wordpress.com. So please, feel free, check it out. And don't forget, subscribe. That's the most important part. There's a little bell under there. I don't know if you can see it there, right there. Yeah, that's it. Just give that a little press. Subscribe to my channel. We're going to have a lot of fun. Promise. Take care, everybody.